Welcome everybody. Now we are going to discuss about counter. What is counter? So counter is a sequential circuit used for counting. So you can design a counter which can start counting from suppose 0, then its value will be suppose 1, then suppose 2, and at the end suppose its value will be 10. Or even you can start your counter from suppose 5, then 6, and then 10. Even it is possible to start counter from 10, okay, after that 9, after that 8, and at the end its value will be 0. So starting count and ending count of the counter will depend upon its design. How you are going to design the counter, so depending on that, starting and ending count are going to vary. So counter is used for counting particular event. Consider one simple example. Suppose assume that this is our class, and this class has one door here and one more door is here. So let's assume that students are entering in this class through this particular door and students are leaving the class through this particular door. So suppose you want to keep track of how many students are entering the class, how many students are leaving the class. Okay, so here you can keep one counter. Okay, so that counter will start counting from suppose 0, 1. So whenever any student is entering in the class, so value of counter will be incremented by 1, right? So we can call this counter as a up counter, right? And on this another door, what you can do, you can keep one more counter. So value of this counter should be decremented by 1 whenever some student leave the class. So we can call this counter as a down counter. So this is one simple application where you can use counter. So counter is used for counting particular event. So what is input to counter? Very important. So input to counter is clock. So clock pulse will be given as input to the counter. So what counter will do? So counter is going to count only this clock pulse. The circuit used for counting clock pulse is called as counter. Whenever one clock pulse is completed, output of counter will be incremented by 1. So we are going to discuss all these points in detail later on. At this stage, just try to understand that input to counter is clock pulse. When one clock pulse is completed, output of counter will be incremented by 1. Now already I told you that while designing counter, we are going to make use of flip-flop. So it is required that you must know what is flip-flop. So by making use of flip-flop, we are going to design counter. So counter is simply a group of flip-flop. Basically, there are two types of counter. One is asynchronous counter. So asynchronous counter is also called as ripple counter. And second type is synchronous counter. So what is the difference between these two counter? So that we are going to see. So already I told you that counter is nothing but it is group of flip-flop, okay? And we have seen that each and every flip-flop has one clock input. So if clock is not given to the flip-flop, output of that flip-flop is not going to change. For example, if I consider this flip-flop, so this flip-flop is JK flip-flop with negative edge triggering. So negative edge triggering means what? Output of this JK flip-flop is going to change as per input J and K when negative edge is detected on the clock pulse. So at that time only this Q is going to change as per J and K. So just by changing values of J and K, output of this JK flip-flop is not going to change. So after changing J and K, what you are supposed to do? You are supposed to give one clock pulse to this JK flip-flop. Then its output will change. So here what I want to say, each and every flip-flop has one clock input. So depending on this clock input, depending on source of this clock input, counters are divided in these two types. Okay, so that's why I am giving trace on this particular point. Now let's see what is source of this clock pulse in case of asynchronous counter. So in case of asynchronous counter, all the flip-flop are not clocked simultaneously. Okay, so counter is nothing but it is a group of flip-flop. In case of asynchronous counter, what happens? All the flip-flops are not clocked simultaneously. means what? External clock pulse. Okay, so external clock pulse is applied only to first flip flop. Output of first flip flop become clock for second flip flop, and output of second flip flop will become clock for third flip flop, and so on. Right? So in case of asynchronous counter, see what is happening. All flip flops, they will not get clock pulse simultaneously. So see this diagram. After that, it will be more clear to you. So this is asynchronous counter. So how many flip flops we have used in order to design this asynchronous counter? Let's assume that 3, 1, 2 and 3. So I can say that this is 3-bit counter. Okay, now see here, just focus on source of clock. So this is our first flip flop. So which is clock for this first flip flop? So external clock pulse. So see, external clock pulse is given as input to this first flip flop. Now what is output of this first flip flop? Now here this flip flop may be JK flip flop or T flip flop. So we are not interested in the type of this flip flop. Okay. So just see from where we are getting clock in case of asynchronous counter. So external clock is given to the first flip flop. What is output of this first flip flop? Q. So that Q will become clock for second flip flop. Right. So this external clock pulse is not given as clock to all the flip flops. Okay. So output of first flip flop is given as clock for second flip flop. Now what is output of this second flip flop? Q. So this Q will become input to clock input for next flip flop, and so on. So if we have such type of arrangement of counter, then it is called as asynchronous counter. Let's see what will happen in case of synchronous counter. So in case of synchronous counter, all the flip flops are clocked simultaneously. Means what? External clock pulse is applied to all the flip flop. See, in case of asynchronous counter, external clock pulse is given to only first flip flop. But in case of synchronous counter, what will happen? This external clock pulse will be given to all the flip flop. So see this design. After that, it will be more clear to you. So here we have synchronous counter. So this synchronous counter is made up of how many flip flop? 3 flip flop. And see, this is external clock pulse. So external clock pulse is given to first flip flop, as well as it is given to second flip flop, as well as it is also given to third flip flop. Okay, so all the flip flops which are present in synchronous counter, they are clocked simultaneously. So if we have such type of arrangement of counter, then it is called as synchronous counter. So what is the difference between asynchronous counter and synchronous counter as far as performance is concerned? So that we will see later on. So this is about different types of counter.